Well, good morning and happy Memorial Day to you. Even though it's tomorrow, I want to take just a second and say thank you to all of those who have given their lives so that we can live in freedom. But it's a quiet morning here, and I've had some requests. I enjoy these walking tours, and it's not trash day, which is really unusual for me and my walking tours, but it's a really quiet Sunday morning. That's a blackbird. We call him Big Boy. I mean, he really owns the place. And there's a mockingbird over here. But this morning we're going to talk about two things. We're going to talk about plumerias, and then I'm going to do a second one for you on spathiphyllum. So this house right here in my neighborhood has this big plumeria right there. And she's got another one that she started up close right there. So let's talk about plumerias. They're commonly called frangipani. When I was a kid in Miami, that's the way we called them. But these are the plants that the flowers are used to make the Hawaiian leis out of, strings of flowers. They are common to most of the tropics, and they are very easy to cross-pollinate. So there's over 100 registered cultivars of them. Most of the flowers have two colors on them. They're fragrant at night, and that attracts the sphinx moth, which is needed to pollinate them. They start very, very easily from cuttings. Most things that start from cuttings, you're better off if you let them, after you cut them, if you let them dry out and callus over for a day or two. It won't keep them from taking root, but it will keep them from rotting off. It's really a critical thing. Here's an example right here. This is an Aralia right here. When I was a kid in Miami, this was really popular. See the variegation on the leaves right there? These were really popular as hedge plants because they start so easily from cuttings. But anyway, if you're going to do a cuttings of plumeria, lay them, they're soft and kind of mushy, so leave them on the ground for a day or two and let them harden off before you put them in the ground. That house I just showed you, she put a couple cuttings out to the street recently, and I picked them up and brought them in my backyard. Now what I do is, when I kind of have a nursery set up in my yard, meaning I've got some spots where I don't have to dig, the soil is soft, and I can put the things in the ground, and then when I decide what I'm eventually going to do with them, I can just dig them up and move them. But I try to avoid areas that have lots of tree roots. So if you're going to use plumeria, there's one good thing and one bad thing about plumeria. The good thing is these beautiful flowers, but the bad thing is that they get a thing called rust, and they get it late in the summer. When I lived out in the farms where it was even more wet, the rust came in like August or something like that, and it's just on the backs of the leaves, but it causes the plants to drop all of their foliage. So what you're going to end up with then is just a bunch of sticks. So what I would tell you to do if you were going to use plumeria in your landscape, what I would tell you to do is use it as a spot accent plant rather than a standalone, because I'll show you a house down here when on their way back. The sun's just right where you can see it. They've got a mass planting of it, but in the winter, all the leaves are gone and it's just a bunch of sticks. This is the other house I was telling you about. See all of those plants in the front there? Not in the mahogany tree. I think that's a Hoya and some orchids in there. But see that, all that frangipani there in the front? They have a low ground cover in the front. That's those bromeliads. They would be well served to have like a middle tier. See, the hedge behind it would be better actually in front of it, so that you'd step down from the frangipani to the hedge to the bromeliads to the grass. But that's beautiful. It's pink. It's white. Lady down the street down here told me she had yellow ones in her yard that change color. I'm not sure if frangipanis can change color like hydrangeas. You know, hydrangeas are blue and pink depending on the pH of the soil. So down in Key West, where these frangipanis are really prevalent, they use them as an accent point in a, up in a bed. And what you'd want to do is, you know, put the plant in the back so it'd be a little taller, and then put some other stuff in the front to disguise the bare sticks during the winter. Anyway, they're a really great addition to the landscape, and the way I like to look at things is, are they low in maintenance? And frangipani certainly is. So that should help out. If you've enjoyed this walk around, you might consider subscribing so you don't miss other ones. And if you've enjoyed this video, stay tuned. I'm going to do another one here in just a minute on spathiphyllum. If you have a chance to give me a thumbs up and subscribe down below, or leave a comment. Is there something else you'd like me to talk about? I love getting out and walking around talking about these tropical plants. So plumerias were requested, and I've got another one coming on Everglades palms, Parotus palms, but I had to find a really nice collection of them, and I found a place down in Palm Beach Gardens. It's got a parking lot full of them. I'll go down there one day and film that for you. So until the next video, have a great Sunday and Memorial Day.